My name is Musa Kaleem Keita. I'm the poet of Harlem. I'm on Wall Street. It's October 22nd, 2011. Wall Street initially got its name from an actual wall that ran from the Hudson River to the East River. The Dutch built a wall about 5 feet high that served as a barrier, a buffer, to keep the Native Americans from attacking them. The Dutch massacred some Native Americans, and that wall served the purpose of keeping the Native Americans from retaliating swiftly. On this side of the wall was African slaves working the farms for the Dutch. From here down to the water, which is very small, the Dutch made countless profits off of the back of slaves and off of the land of the indigenous people, Native Americans. There's a plaque up the street on a bank that explains exactly what I'm saying. This is not any esoteric or Masonic information that's kept from the public. The plaque is up the street in public view, plain view. Anyone could read it. But Wall Street, there was an actual wall right here to keep out the Native Americans from retaliating against the Dutch. And the church behind me is a church where one of the signers of the Declaration of Independence and the Founding Fathers, Alexander Hamilton, is buried. That's Trinity Church behind me. And a lot of people may not know, but in the Wall Street community they know, the first black man to have a $1 billion company. He started at 99 Wall Street. His name is Reginald F. Lewis. He passed some time ago. But he was different from a lot of Wall Street bankers and tycoons and moguls. He was a very charitable man. But Wall Street literally was a wall to keep Native Americans from retaliating on this island of Manhattan.
A lot of people have different views, and everyone here came from all over the United States and even the world. But the idea is that corporate greed and corporate power has taken over, hijacked the political system. And the bailouts have bankrupted the people.
And so what's your ultimate goal?
That's our discussion. I mean, what we're doing, and what's very important for people to understand, is this is a different way of doing business, right? Different way of doing politics. This isn't about demands or what our goals are. This is about getting people together, empowering them with the process, giving them a space, having them have discussions. And from those discussions, something organic percolates that will blow your mind beyond the stuff of what a politician would tell you they want or they need. We've seen it in Egypt, man, with Mubarak. After 30, 40 years of being in power, people rose up and they believe that they can bring a different reality. And that's what we're doing over here. People are energized and people are hearing each other and their ideas. And everyone agrees that shit's fucked up, but that's a perfect foundation to start a conversation. And from that, we're working on principles of solidarity with each other and the world. And from there, demand.
We were actually doing a march from here, Liberty Plaza, to Union Square, 14th Street. It was pretty successful until our way back. I went to the back of the line to check on some of the disabled and older people. They were fine, so I went into a store to get a drink, get a Gatorade, came out, and I saw down the line that a lot of the people had got stopped and slowed down and whatnot. And I didn't really know why, so I ran up to try to get close and see what was going on. And as soon as I got there, it was like somebody clicked the little red button and the police just went chaotic and hectic. And you see people just flying around and papers getting thrown up in the air and just chaos. And I see my friend, she's recording a cop a cop trying to arrest another protester. And the cop knocks her down on the ground, and I went to go help her out. And then the cop pushes me, and I get bum rushed, and he punches me in my face a couple times, about three times. I got scars and stuff right there, you know, busted lip, you know. And I get knocked over the barrier. And after I get knocked over the barrier, about four cops kick me in my stomach, knock the breath out of me, you know, hit me with a baton, telling me to stop resisting arrest. And I was just laying there. And you know, it's just surprising the dehumanization that these cops did to themselves, because they were laughing. You know, they were laughing as all this was taking place. And you know, it was just incredible. It was a bad experience, but you know, it worked out for the better, because I know everybody that was there watching are now supporting us. And you know, they had everybody that I saw with cameras, and you know, that were innocent bystanders that were just on the sidewalks and watching, they all had compassion in their eyes, and I could feel they were there for me. And the second I got into the truck, I knew that it was a good thing. It was a good outcome. You know, that's what we caused and purpose.
There's nothing rioty or radical about the protest. When we had reached the precinct, my arresting officer, when he brought us in, there was another officer that had asked him who gave the word to arrest these people, and he just looked at her and said, "I'm just as confused as you are." And she had said, "Oh, so we're holding these people without a reason, and nobody gave a command or anything to do it." And he just shook his head like he had no clue. And even he had mentioned, he was like, "I this whole thing was a mess. I don't know what happened."
It's like a jungle sometimes, it makes me wonder how I keep from going under. It's like a jungle sometimes, it makes me wonder.
I'm Russell Simmons, I'm here to support the people who are trying to get the power back to the people. And the idea is the power to the people and not to the corporation. I want to see legislation, I want to see change. I want to see so that we have, that the corporation, for instance, when we go to war because corporations are in part responsible for lobbying for war, because they sell war materials. But the reason that people go to jail for nonviolent crimes in many cases is because there are lobbyists promoting laws that put people in jail for a sustained amount of time for nonviolent crimes. And you look at the unions being disbanded. The unions are disbanded because corporations want them disbanded. And it goes on and on. All the specific demands that are made by these people are made by these people because corporations are pushing back against what people want. And they're making the politicians work for them instead of the people who elected them. Always young people start revolutions. Always young people have creative ideas to make the country better or the world better. So I need you to be out here with us.
Those who wish to follow me, I welcome with my hands, and the red sun sings at last into the hills of gold. And peace to this young warrior without the sound of guns.
If I could recollect before my hood days, I sit and reminisce, thinking of bliss and a good day. I stop and stare at the younger, my heart goes to them. They tested with stress that they under, and nowadays things change. Everyone's ashamed of the